Please join us in singing, "How Great Thou Art."
And feel the gentle breeze. Continue our prayers, our deepest condolences to the granddaughter, Danielle Damer, and all the family and friends, those who are joining us through the live stream of this Mass on behalf of St. Michael Catholic Church and parishioners. Extend that to you, and at this funeral for the Mass of Christian burial for Doug and Shirley Owens. We continue our prayers in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father, the Father of mercies, and the God of all consolation be with you all. Brothers and sisters, at the beginning of this funeral, we remember the gift of baptism that the Lord has given us to enter into his life through his death and resurrection and baptism, and for the Holy Spirit, the gift of the Holy Spirit that is given to us through baptism. And we have those signs of baptism with holy water, which I'll sprinkle in a few moments upon their remains, and the Easter candle at the altar here, which is a sign, a symbol of Christ, and the flame, this a symbol of the Holy Spirit, the life, the love of God, that came to dwell within them at baptism. In the waters of baptism, Shirley and Doug died with Christ. May now they share with him in eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, who willed that your only begotten Son, having conquered death, should pass over into the realm of heaven, grant, we pray, to your servants, your departed servants, Shirley and Doug, that with the mortality of this life overcome, they may gaze eternally on you, their Creator and Redeemer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated as we listen to our scripture readings.
Reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more mourning or death, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat at the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land.
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with the word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
What happens beyond death for the faithful Christian? It seems so final and sad. Surely this is true for those who know Shirley and Doug the most. Family and friends and those whose lives were so much touched by them and such an important part. To others, that such a Christian witness has died is a great loss. But only seeing the death of a faithful Christian from that worldview, from that view, would be only looking through the eyes of this world. The saint of the 18th century, St. John Vianney, says, "The eyes of this world see no further than this life, but the eyes of the Christian see deep into eternity." To see into eternity and more deeply and more deeply each day. We need not just the light of human reason, but the gift to receive the gift of faith, like Shirley and Doug did. And God's revelation in the scriptures helps us to see that eternity, God's life. The book of Samuel says, man sees the appearance, but God looks into the heart. Scriptures are filled with references to the unseen world hinted at by what we see in this world, but also what happens to the faithful Christian after death. From the book of Revelations we just heard, I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former had passed away. God will always be with them, no more death, mourning, tears, wailing, or pain. From the Gospel of John today, Jesus says, there are many dwelling places. He desires us to be where he is. And St. Paul's letter to the Thessalonians says in another place, what no eye has seen and no ear has heard, what the mind of man cannot visualize, all that God has prepared for those who love him. And then today, was read from the letter to the Thessalonians again, we want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have fallen asleep, to make sure that you do not grieve for them as others do. So grief is always a part, but as St. Paul says, we grieve, but nonetheless we have hope in the Lord. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that in the same way God rose him from the dead, so will he bring those who have fallen asleep in him. The mystery of eternity, God's life, was present in Doug and Shirley's life while with us here on earth. Some of the ways that's evident that I became aware of through the family, and they married and brought together with much as love as possible, a blended family. Doug's most cherished service was to bring his family together on big holidays, particularly Christmas. The Lord loves to give us gifts, and he prepares us to receive them. This is how Doug reflected the Lord. He prepared Christmas for Christmas by getting gifts for his 20 grandchildren, carefully wrapping each one of them individually. And then he brought the big ham. They both supported each other through the loss of children. I noticed in the obituary that they each lost children before they passed away. So they drew near to each other, they supported each other. The Lord draws near to us when we're suffering, particularly. Shirley was one of those people who lit up a room with her smile and made everyone feel special. The Lord has that individual, in reality, that individual care for each one of us individually, even in the details of our lives. Shirley saw the good side of the Catholic Church. Something attracted her to the presence of the Lord in it, even before she moved in with her granddaughter here in Minnesota. But living with the Damer family sealed the deal, as she said. She flashed that contagious smile every time she went to Mass with the Damers. She showed me a picture of her and Doug in St. Peter's Square when I went to visit her to bring her the sacraments. I was in front of the Basilica in Rome. She must have kept that and brought it with her to Minnesota. And then it seems that watching Pope Francis's blessing at the beginning of this pandemic sparked something in her to ask for the initiation sacraments for Holy Communion and to become profess Catholic faith. To hear about and witness someone who continues to reach out to the Lord to the end of their lives is a great blessing and a reminder, inspiration for me, and I think all of us, to continue to reach out to the Lord each day, no matter what stage of life we're in. So as we offer Mass today, we do so with the perspective of eternal life that God has given us. As important as we cared for Doug and Shirley throughout their lives or at different stages of their lives, to continue to do so by praying for them. The greatest prayer we can pray is the Mass, and that they will be freed from any sin that kept them from God and enter into a deeper eternal life with them, with Him. As we honor them, grieve their loss, we also commend them to their Lord in the trust and confidence and the hope of the fullness of eternal life promised to those who believe. Please stand now and offer, as we offer our prayers petition, and join our hearts and minds to these prayers which have been prepared. And also in the silence of our hearts, those personal intentions that we have. The response to each of these prayers is, Lord, hear our prayer. In baptism, Doug and Shirley received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead them over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may receive Doug and Shirley into eternal happiness with the company of all the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the bishops and priests of the church and all who preach the gospel may be given the strength to express in action the word they proclaim. We pray to the Lord. For all those in need of healing, especially the spiritual wound of hopelessness, that they also may find and receive the healing of the Savior's forgiveness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have prayed for and helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of our brother Doug and sister Shirley, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's pause now for a moment and offer our personal prayers in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here to worship God in faith, that we may be gathered together again in His kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers. Strengthen our belief that Your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that Your servants, Shirley and Doug, will also rise again. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, Your Son, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
please join us in singing Hail Mary, Gentlewoman.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, on the sacrificial offerings we present to you for the souls of your servants. And just as you bestowed on them the dignity of the Christian faith, grant them also its reward. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself. So from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess his resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael, the archangel, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, his assistant Andrew, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servants Shirley and Doug, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you are as our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to possess you within my soul. Since I am unable at this moment to receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as being already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Please join us in singing On Eagle's Wings.
Show.
Let us pray. Through these sacrificial gifts which we have received, O Lord, bestow on your departed servants your great mercy, and to those you have endowed with the grace of baptism, grant also the fullness of eternal joy. Through Christ our Lord. Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of our brother and sister in Christ. May our farewell express our affection for them. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet them again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, conquers death itself. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother and sister in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died with Christ, they will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servants and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother and sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has ended. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that sings.
my chains.